eternal in the heaven. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside his still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, be comforted. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. At this time, we'll hand over.
Your blessing right now for the family, for all of us who love Elder Glover. Lord, we ask your blessings upon this congregation today though the heart may be heavy, you are God of love and great heart. Send it down from heaven right now, Lord. Lift up the heavy burden and touch the heart in the name of Jesus. Amen.
I pledge you remain standing for our scripture reading. The Old Testament reading is going to be found in Psalms 14, verses 4 through 8, led by Minister Irma Green, followed by the New Testament scripture reading, 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verses 5 through 8, led by Minister Robin White. Let's receive from you this one.
Lord, the Old Testament scripture, Psalm 34, verses 4 through 8, and it reads, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and deliver them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Everybody praise the Lord. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 5 through 8. But watch thou in all things endure affliction. Do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearance. God always bless you to read of his word.
Amen.
You may be seated at this time.
Yeah.
And at this time, we got one of our very own
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
As far as the Lord.
Time
here representing my family. Uncle Melvin couldn't be here. Uncle Melvin couldn't be here. And Linda couldn't be here. Linda Dolan and Jackie couldn't be here because of the reason why we're wearing these masks. So the family. Family asked me to speak on their behalf.
Yes.
I want to begin and end my comments by saying thank you to everyone who's attended here. Because other than the world in its conditions now, you took a risk in being here. And love has a way of doing that. So we want to really thank you for that. The Glover Singleton family were bond way before Rochester. It started as brothers and sisters. Children became the best of friends. And so in that, the first one that came here was my Uncle Wilbert, and he called his best friend cousin and said, if you want something better, then you need to leave Montgomery and come where you can do that. And my cousin, he was more than that. He was definitely a father, because I didn't have that role model in my life. Every young boy, they need to know what their role is.
Amen.
Because the world confuses it and makes you think you should be something else. But to my father, my uncle, my mentor, I don't know, a conversation that went by, because his conversations, it wasn't about football, definitely wasn't about baseball, basketball either. But just about every conversation, he would talk about work. And how you need to work. Because don't forget now, you got to get up and go to work. And so that type of work ethic was instilled in anyone, because he was a man's man. His word was his word. And if he told you no, you can keep talking. You could absolutely keep talking, but the conversation. Conversations that I endured and gravitate to him, because that's the type of man I wanted to be for my family. No matter the hurts in life, whether you go through surgery or you fall down, healing only takes place from the inside out. And no matter how long it takes to heal, what's left is an indelible scar.